A good mystery is written mostly within the confines of reality, because reality is all we understand. If the supernatural element is involved, then the viewer must be given evidence and logic to determine and understand how these new rules that have been introduced work. I've always disliked things like the butterfly effect, ghosts, or magic in mystery stories, because the logic is normally thrown out the window when it comes to explaining why things are happening. I don't mean to say that magic or ghosts can't be incorporated into mystery, however, the rules that govern their ability must be explained by the end of the narrative. The butterfly effect is the stupidest setup for any story, as the cause is absolutely no correlation with the effect, and we accept on faith that, yes indeed, stepping on that butterfly 10,000 years ago did set off a chain of events that caused the anime to become real. There's also a ton of crap in the Harry Potter movies that just wave away important inconsistencies or plot points like, the world in which the narrative is set is magic, just roll with it. You know, like using one-off items that never get mentioned again, or having overpowered superhuman-like abilities that negate nearly all danger, Hermione's time-turning necklace being a pretty egregious one, but obviously it was written for children so leniency is given. It's more of a fantasy of a fantasy for kids, rather than a logical story in a fantastical world. What I'm trying to explain is that a whimsical universe's rules must be consistent and well thought out before any story can be told. This is why people find retconning events to be the mark of a writer who has written themselves into a corner, or somebody who has no clear direction for which the narrative is to flow. So if the demon's origins are unexplained or the magical world is filled with wonder, anything fantastical that affects the narrative must be established early, remain consistent in its rules of existence, and sufficiently explained by the end. This brings me to Petscop and how we should view its story. Petscop leaves a lot for us to drudge through in terms of the who, what, when, where, and how. And that's its purpose. Not quite an ARG, but still has the depth within the videos for us to play detective. My way of viewing Petscop is basically this. Never assume ghosts or magic did it. Because at that point you would essentially be saying, I can't explain this yet, so therefore it must be something beyond comprehension.
This is how religion starts.
And if you do start down that rabbit hole, you start finding other things that you can't comprehend, and use it as proof for your ghost and magic theory. It's pathological and lazy. For example, when Paul becomes the Shadow Monster Man, is it magic? Did he become a ghost? A ghoul? Or was it when Paul walked into the basement entrance of the flower shack, the game scaled his brightness down in relation to how far he had entered the entrance, and eventually was turned completely black when he reached a certain point to simulate walking into darkness. He then clipped out the right side of the stairs before entering the shack, possibly by an exploit inserted by the creator, possibly not. Because he didn't walk up out of the basement stairway, he retained his current level of brightness, absolute black. This would also explain why he turns back to his normal color when he once again walks to the top of the stairs, as the game updates his level of brightness from absolute black to normal, as that would be the level of brightness for the player model assigned to that area of the stairs. We can then go on to theorize that because of his new brightness level, the game now uses that stored value in Paul's character to determine the opacity of the windmill, which Paul can now see. We also see Marvin enter the windmill completely black as well, insinuating that yes, the windmill can only be seen and therefore accessed by a player whose model's brightness level is set to whatever value necessary to be completely black. With logical thinking and considering the medium of a video game which Petscop takes place, we have solidly theorized that the player's level of brightness can determine the windmill's opacity. Now, this isn't new information and the reasoning was all pretty straightforward, but I'm sure at one point or another for many people it wasn't. The lesson I'm trying to impart here is with the complex nature of the Petscop story, try not to jump to tropes like kid gets sucked into video game world, altered game disc or cartridge, or this is all an allegory for X, X being whatever issue or story you're familiar with. And I'm not judging or trying to look down on anyone. If you believe you have proof of ghosts and magic, you best present it for scrutiny. I had a video with 2K views that I took down because I later had to agree that what I had was essentially misinformation that I really didn't want to let go of because I invested so much time into the theory. So now that Petscop 16 is out, and when going forward with researching and theorizing about Petscop, keep in mind, never assume ghosts or magic did it. Try to find correlation, cause, and effect. The supernatural works best when it's used sparingly, and I think the Petscop creator knows this. Also, read the progress document on Reddit. Even if you're adept with Petscop or you just got here, everything that's been found is there. Every week I see people posting the same finding that was found a year ago. Good luck.